Good morning.
It's good to be in the Lord's house today. Y'all got quiet, so I figure you're ready to get started here. Just want to welcome everybody. We're glad you've come this way. Glad the Lord's led you this way. If you're visiting with us, just make yourself right at home. We don't try to put on no airs here at New Hope. We're just simple country folk that love the Lord, and we're here to worship Him today. So we ask you to join with us in doing that. And we'll start by singing a song together.
If you would stand and turn to page 57, Amazing Grace.
This morning. Praise the Lord. By way of announcements today, I want to let you know that this Tuesday night at 6:30, there will be a meeting about Bible school here at the church. So anyone who's interested in being a part or helping out with Bible school, please be here Tuesday night. I also wanted to mention that we had our church election this week, and I appreciate everybody who came out and took their time and participated in that. We also had a pastor election this time, and I'm very glad to say that the result was unanimous. I was very thankful for that, and I want you to know that that humbles me a lot, and I don't take that lightly at all. The confidence that you have put in me, or that you've shown that you've put in me, I take that to heart very much. And I just desire your prayers that the Lord will continue to guide us and bless us here at New Hope, and that He'll have His way with all of us. That's my desire, and I'm sure it's yours too. And you stuck with me for a while longer anyway. But again, thank you for that. Any other announcements today? Senior trip on Friday. Today's the last day to sign up.
Yeah, and I wanted to announce we're going to have kind of a family fun day on the 26th of this month. So not this Saturday, but the following Saturday at Deep Creek. And so we just want everybody in the church that can and wants to come. Try to get out there. The pavilion and stuff were taken, but we're just going to try to get some larger spots on the other side of the river. And just everybody come out and bring your own food and get your own tubes, and we'll just hang out together and have a kind of family fun day, and everybody can go tubing together. Figure everybody get there around 1, you know, sometime in the afternoon. But just wanted to give an opportunity for families to get together. Have some fun in the summer. I'm sorry?
Next Saturday?
Yes.
Not next Saturday, Saturday after.
Saturday 26. After, 26. Mm-hmm. Saturday, 26th at 1. We'll just meet at Deep Creek. Have fun.
Family fun day at Deep Creek on the 26th at 1 o'clock. Glad everybody can come. Any other announcements? You can leave tonight at 6 o'clock. All right, so we did have our, as I mentioned, our church election this past week, and I want to recognize Sister Gloria now. She's going to come and read to us who the nominations are for the upcoming year.
Horribly hot outside to enjoy that time together. Also, like to give thanks to the contacting committee for all your hard work and pulling this off. Appreciate your time and your service. I would like to go ahead and read the results for the election. Sunday School Director, Denny Wood. Assistant Sunday School Director, Josh Jamison and Ernie Sherman. Sunday School Clerk, Pam Morgan. Assistant Sunday School Clerk, Diane Dillard. Treasurer, Heather Wood. Assistant Treasurer, Tara Dillard. Building Fund Treasurer, Larry Phillips. Assistant Building Fund Treasurer, Cindy Thompson. Birthday Offerings, Emily Bryson. Flower Fund, Gloria Painter. Assistant Flower Fund, Sue Adams. Ushers, Johnny Buchanan. Tim Crow, Spencer Norris, Travis Painter, Robert Paris, Aaron Williams, Zach Wood. Church Clerk, Rita Norris. Assistant Church Clerk, Patty Inslee. Reporter, Gloria Painter. Assistant Reporter, Amy Harris. Pianist, Sheena Holland. Assistant Pianist, Patty Inslee, Jerry Hensley, and Sue Norman. Choir Director, Crystal Johnson. Assistant Choir Director, Brett Bryson, Chuck Norris, Marvin Schuler. Monthly Singings, Kayla Holland. VBS Director, Greg and Jesse Stewart. Assistant VBS Director, Rita Norris. Special Events Committee, Crystal Johnson, Heather Wood, Delaney Crow, Tammy Schuler, Ashley Crow, Gloria Painter. Christmas Play Director, Judy Schuler. Tate Ministry, Stephen Buchanan. Assistant Tate Ministry, Darren Sutton, Josh Jamison, Spencer Norris, Bill Thompson. Fellowship Hall Overseer, Kenny and Cheryl Crow. Janitor, Richard Frady. Executive Committee Rep, Darren Sutton. Contacting Committee, Vicki Bradley, Johnny Buchanan, Gloria Kainer, Lee Inslee Jr., Richard Frady, Pam Morgan, Tammy Schuler, Phyllis Bullock. Decorations Committee, Kathy Barnes, Cheryl Crow, Delaney Crow, Helen Painter, Louis Jean Morgan. Band Committee, Johnny Buchanan, Stephen Buchanan, Bill Thompson. Building Committee, Johnny Buchanan, Ray Faircloth, Scott Farmer, Palmer Fisco, Michael Johnson, Larry Phillips, Barry Stevens, Chuck Norris. Overseer of Cemetery, Don Schuler. Assistant Overseer of Cemetery, Brad Stillwell. Grounds Cemetery Committee, Todd Balcom, Daryl Buchanan, Johnny Buchanan, Chad Kay, Mark Collin, Tim Crow, Benji Dillard, Lee Inslee Jr., Jason Fisher, Ronnie Kelly, Spencer Norris, Robert Harris, Larry Phillips, Jacob Porter, Brandon Pet Presley, Don Schuler, Barry Stevens, Bill Thompson, Aaron Williams, Clayton Dillard, Matthew Kay, Anthony Kay. We would also like that the committees get together and pick a head of chair and let Richard Frady know who that will be next Sunday or within the next few weeks. Thank you.
Thank you, Lori. Any questions or comments on the nominated officers? Do I hear a motion that we approve them for the upcoming year?
I make a motion to approve them for the coming year.
Second was from Larry. All right, all those in favor, let it be known by saying aye.
Aye.
Okay, thank you very much. All right, it's time for our children's sermon.
Morning. Do you guys see what I brought with me? Look, I brought something. Do you know what it is? It looks like a big mess, doesn't it? But do you know what it is?
It's a bird's nest.
Yeah.
I know. I went out one day.
Babies
go in there. So one day, I went out to my greenhouse, and look, they made it in one of my empty pots from my greenhouse. But some Carolina wrens had made a bird's nest. And look, you can see down in there. See? So they abandoned this one, and they made another one in another pot, like right next to it. And they had some babies in it. They had eggs. And then they hatched. And I watched the mom and dad, and they would bring back bugs and caterpillars and all this stuff and take care of the babies. But I got thinking, who feeds all the birds? Where do birds find food? You ever see birds at the grocery store buying boxes of cereal? No? No, you never see birds at the grocery store. Do you think birds use realtors and they buy a house? No, they find all this stuff. There's none in there, but that's where they live. That's where they live. Yeah, it's empty. It's empty. But who takes care of all the birds? Who finds them their food and finds them a place to live and makes sure they're warm in the winter? Does anybody do that for them? Or do you think God does it? Does God take care of all the birds? He takes care of all the planet, doesn't he? And all the animals and stuff. And he gave them all the knowledge and all the things to be able to take care of themselves. And he makes sure they got food and stuff. And so I was thinking about how neat it was that these birds made a nest in my greenhouse and they got to live there for a while, and I got to watch them, but it reminded me of a verse when Jesus talked about the birds and where they live and what they eat, and I wanted to share it with you, because Jesus was speaking, and it was in Matthew, in chapter 6, verse 26. And Jesus is speaking, and he says, "Behold the fowls," or birds, "of the air, for they sow not, neither do they reap, nor gather into barns. Yet your heavenly..."
Bird.
I know. Hold on one second, okay? I know. He says, "Yet your heavenly Father feedeth them." And then he says, "Are you not much better than they?" And so Jesus was talking about birds, and he was doing kind of an object lesson like this. And he was saying, think about birds and animals and how they're taken care of. And nobody has to feed them, but they're okay. And nobody has to find them a home. They're okay, right? Because God takes care of them. And then think about how much more special you are than some bird flying around outside. Jesus didn't die on the cross for some bird, did he? No, God gave his only son for us, not for animals or not for anything like that. And God takes care of all those birds and all those animals. Think about how much more God would take care of us, the ones that he gave his only son for. And so it's a reminder that when we get to see animals like rabbits out in our yard, or squirrels, or even birds, and see where they live, and all of that fun stuff, that it reminds us they're taken care of, and so are we. So much more we are by God in heaven, a Father that loves us and cares for us so much that he would give his only son. All right. So I hope that'll remind you guys when you see animals around, because we get to see lots of animals where we live, don't we? That you can think they're taken care of. And so are you, because God loves you so much more, even more than what he's taking care of all the animals in all the world. Okay? All right, let's have the pastor pray for us.
Lord, thank you for taking care of us, for seeing to it that all our needs are met. God, just help us to trust you every day. Thank you for the reminders you've given to us all around us in this world, this beautiful world that you've made. May it assure us and give us the hope that you want us to have. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Bowling.
Sing. Thanks, Stephen, for the Sunday school lesson this morning. Great Sunday school lesson. Listen, we have Sunday school each Sunday morning at 10 o'clock in here. And the good thing about it is each year, each week, you get a new teacher. So you don't get bored with your teacher anymore. Stephen did a great job this morning. Let me tell you something. I'm glad I'm saved. I know tribulations come and trials. I ain't like being the old dog to the rest of the world now, Christian. They make fun of us, laugh at us, criticize us, but they don't know. Do you know? That's this song here this morning. I have a source of strength that they don't know how to come up against, let me tell you. It don't make me weaker when they criticize. It makes me stronger. Ain't that amazing? It works right the opposite of what they think it's going to do. It makes me stronger. Donnie, I just love the fact that I know the truth. And the truth has made me free. Hallelujah this morning. We just sang about the blood. I'll sing about it again. Because that's the one thing that we need in our churches. Remember to keep the main thing the main thing. And that's the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ, shedding his blood that I could be free. have a source of strength when I am weak. That takes me through when life is pressing me. I have a source of power from above. I'm covered over by a shield of love.
Now I'm his praise is all. Leading me along paths. job of my age, Chris.
Before you do that. When I can see no way, he makes a way. That's the kind of God I serve today. That's the kind of God that he is. And as we were singing that, I was just thinking, you know, I am so glad he makes a way. Because a lot of times I can't see which way to go, which way to turn in my life. And there may be somebody else here in that condition today. That's how you feel. That's how it is in your life today. I want to encourage you, turn to the Lord. He can make a way for you and me. And most of all, he can make a way of salvation. If there's even one among us today that doesn't know him, has never accepted Jesus into your life, he can save you today. Amen. And he will if you'll ask him to. If he's dealing with your heart, you need to come and call on his name. And he'll come into your life. And he'll save your soul, and he'll write your name in the Lamb's Book of Life, and he'll make you his child today. Amen. That's his desire for you. That's his desire for all of us, that none would perish, but that all would come to repentance. Yeah. Brother, we might just let the big preacher preach today, if that's all right. We may still need you here in a minute, but we're going to follow the Lord for now, and it's up to us all. You let God have his way with you, and he'll have his way with the next person and the next person. That's how it works. But we have to be obedient. We have to trust him and do what he wants each one of us to do. So I want us to stand this morning. You need God to make a way for you, he can do that. You need him to save your soul today, he can do that. He can do all things, exceeding abundantly above all that we ask or think. There is nothing that is too hard for our God. Whatever it is you need from him today, he can supply. You just need to trust him. You come to him this morning, he'll meet you here, and you'll not walk away disappointed. I can promise you that. As long as you come sincerely and mean it in your heart, God will do the rest.
Through your precious blood, I found pardon.
love us. You feel like God's leading you to be a part of this church. You believe that you hope it's within your church home. This is where God wants you. The doors of this church are always open. I just felt impressed to give you a special invitation today. You feel like that's the way God's leading you? Now's your chance. Come and let that be known. Between you and the Lord.
Ernie, can I share something God taught me this week?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, this might shock my own children, but when I was 18, God had to teach me a lesson about the joy of my salvation. And I had had a year where I desperately needed God's forgiveness before I moved here. And didn't realize it until I had moved here when I was 18. And I know everybody thinks, you know, Greg was the hellion that got in trouble whenever he was in high school. However, I had a year where I was not living for the Lord, even though I knew I was saved.
Sure.
I knew I had been brought up right. I knew I had Christian grandpa who was a pastor. I had parents who were Christians. I had been well-loved, well-taught, went to every vacation Bible school, went to Sunday school. I knew the answers and I knew the stories and I had been saved. However, I was not living for him, and I knew that, and nobody else did but me. And when I moved here, he gave me complete and total forgiveness. I sought him out and he answered my prayers. And he changed my life.
Amen.
And he gave me a man of God.
Thank you.
And he put me in a place where I could minister to children, and he put me in this church, and he blessed me with the opportunity to serve him and help our youth when I can. And I guess what I'm saying is this past couple weeks, God has given me some fruits of our labors that I can see his spirit working. Mm-hmm. And so I want to thank my people for treating me up in the way that I should go. So when I got old, I did not depart from it. And I'm praying for our youth. I truly believe if you're hurting over your child, God will bring them back.
Amen.
And that's what we're praying for. I was just blown away at a little story I got this week from a woman who said, "We're in church. I want you to know what you meant in my life. And my kids are in church." And I thank God for being a part of that. And I truly believe he will rescue our youth from this culture if we just keep praying. I believe it.
Amen.
They know we love them. But most of all, they know the Savior.
Anybody else? Something on your heart. All right, can't you say the preacher didn't give you a chance, can you? Nope. Maybe we'll catch you next time. Is that all right? All hearts and minds clear.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
We say one more.
We say one more.
I feel like there's unfinished business too.
Yes,
not up to me. It's up to whoever God might be dealing with. So yes, I'll say one more.
There's a day just out in front of us, I know will surely come. That eastern sky will open wide, revealing God's dear Son. And I know from here to heaven, it's but the twinkling of an eye. And in the midst of all his glory, we'll hear the sweetest cry. Welcome home, I knew you'd come. Welcome home, you're here for good. And look around, was it worth the wait? Welcome home, step through the gate. I believe at least for me, I'll see my mom and dad, my brothers and my sisters. Everywhere you look are friends. Oh, the greetings will be precious from those we've loved so dear. No mortal man has ever seen or heard what we'll hear. I knew you'd come. Welcome home. You're here for good. And look around. Was it worth the wait? Welcome home. Step through the gate. I believe at least for and my sisters, everywhere you look are friends. Oh, the greetings will be precious from those we've loved so dear. No mortal man has ever seen or hear what we'll hear. Welcome home, I knew.
let me know.
Isn't it good to know that you know that there's a God alive? A lot of folks think, well, he's dead. Well, he's not. Because we've been talking to him, ain't we? So he's alive and he's well, and I'm glad to be here at New Hope Gun today. I thank God for the blessing of God. I like to go to a place where you take God with you, then when you get there, God's already there. When you get there, he makes his presence known. And a lot of folks say, well, how can you know of the presence of God? Well, honey, if you've ever been out of the presence of God, you'll understand that there is a God. My friend, there is a Lord Jesus sitting at the right hand of your majesty on high, who's making intercession on our behalf every day. Hey, listen, a lot of folks said, well, I believe God down at the church. But honey, let me tell you something. He said, I'll be with you until the end. Hey, so I ain't glad that don't you have a God that loves you no matter where you go. All of your activities, there is a God of glory, hallelujah, that will be you and you, hallelujah. To you, my friend, hey, to you cross over that river, there's a God that loves you, who died for you, and gave it all.
Amen.
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 God bless you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Brother, let me read something. Let me read something real quick. This, I feel the Lord impressed me to read this. This ain't preaching tonight. Just don't get nervous. But in 1 Peter 5, this has been on my mind all the service. I've been nervous. I'm real nervous. Should have known God was on the scene. Amen. But anyway, it says this, the elders which are among you I exhort, whom am also elder, and witness the sufferings of Christ, and also a partaker of the glory that shall be revealed, feed the flock of God which is among you, taking the oversight thereof, not by constraint, but willingly, not for filthy lucre, but of ready mind, neither as being lords over God's heritage, but being examples to the flock. Now this next verse is what I'm going to get to. I may not read it. I may blow a gasket on it. Because I believe he's here this morning.
Amen.
Now do all that. He said, feed the flock. Take care of them, brother. But he says this.
Yes.
And when the chief shepherd shall appear.
Yes.
That's good this morning, ain't
it?
When the chief shepherd shall appear, you shall receive a crown of glory that fadeth not away.
Amen.
I'd like to say the chief
Amen.
Shepherd
Amen.
Has appeared this
Amen.
Morning.
Amen.
Amen. If you don't get in, it's your fault.
Amen.
He's here this morning. I feel a comforting, nudging spirit today.
Yes.
Mind the Lord. Amen.
Yes.
This says this, in Joel, in the valley of decisions, multitudes and multitudes.
Yes.
You could be there right now, but God is on when the chief shepherd
Yes.
shall appear.
Amen.
That could be today, folks.
Yeah.
Get ready. He's coming, folks.
Amen.
He's already here this morning.
Yes.
That's all I felt like saying. The chief shepherd. We got a lot of little bitty chiefs, but we got one head shepherd this morning. Amen.
Yes.
He shall appear.
Yes.
Thank you, God.
Sure you don't want to join this church today? Only if God wants you to, and I'm just
right
there.
Amen.
He knows when that is, if that is. So we trust him, but they don't.
Amen.
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 Amen. I feel better. And I appreciate you.
Amen.
I do.
Amen.
A young man, how old are you? 12? He is not afraid. He's not ashamed to do what God tells him to do. I appreciate that about you, brother. Don't you never lose that, okay?
Man.
That's right.
Amen.
I'm proud of all our young people, like Jesse was saying. This culture is trying so hard to consume them.
Yes.
To take them away from us and take them away from this place. Greater is he that is in me.
Amen.
Yes.
Right.
I like that.
Amen. I'm glad I'm just one of them little chiefs that
all of these lies. Yes.
do so. Sir?
Yeah, this is a wonderful church here, and wonderful music, and wonderful people. I've been praying about something that the only thing that I miss when I come to church, I would like to hear God's word proclaimed, preached. And maybe I'm out of hand. I've been praying about it, and I just wanted to share that with you.
See y'all.
Our hearts and minds clear today.
Amen.
I'm so thankful for what God's done here today. I've truly been blessed. I needed this. I'm sure a lot of other people did too.
Amen.
We're just unhooked right there. God bless you. Hope to see you next time.
Amen.